Hi, this is Ben with Ben Talks Talent. Last week, I made a video and the topic was 9 different things you can do as someone who is unemployed to land a job. And it was generally speaking pretty positive from a feedback perspective. But I had several people reach out to me and go, Ben, all of your tips were once you have an interview. What about those of us who are applying and applying and applying, but we're not getting invitations to interview? What then? It's a great question. This video is about those of you who are trying to get invited to the interviews. You're applying, you're not having any luck. Today, I'm gonna give you a handful of tips that will help you get invited to that interview. So today, I have 11 tips. And these are 11 tips that should help you get called or emailed to do an interview. I know a lot of you out there are trying to find a job and there are more unemployed people, there are less jobs, it is a competitive market. These are some of the things you can do to make sure you have a better chance of being called to an interview. So the first one is making sure you have a great LinkedIn profile. I know you're probably seeing this on LinkedIn or perhaps YouTube, and it seems like I'm just saying what everybody else is saying, but I have to tell you, it's incredibly important. I work for a company and 100% of the candidates we present to our clients are people we find. And one of the principal methods that we go and find them is LinkedIn. We don't even have a database. The world is our database. So making it so people like myself and my team and my company can find you is important. Have a great professional LinkedIn profile, you know, have a nice header that's applicable. Make sure you have robust details about what you did at your job that includes some of the, you know, the industry specific terminology and keywords. All those things are important. You know, as recruiters, we build Boolean search strings. And then that brings up people who fit those search strings. You want to be one of those people. So it increases the probability that people reach out to you about opportunities. When you're a candidate, you want to find roles and you want to apply to them, but it's even better if in addition to that, people are reaching out to you because you set up a great LinkedIn profile to help them come and find you. When you look at that skills section, some people look at that and they shrug it off. I don't need that. You do need it. Because if you put the different terms there that are gonna help someone like me find you, it increases the probability that someone is gonna send you an in-mail saying, hey, you could be a good fit for this job. You want that to happen, especially if you're in the job market. The next thing I wanna do is select open to work. So, you know, open to new opportunities. You can actually go into LinkedIn, go into your settings and select open to work. It's just an indicator that you are interested in looking at and exploring new opportunities as a recruiter. You know, we send out in-mails and we actually have a percentage of people who accept it, decline or ignore. Recruiters know you are gonna respond to their message. It's just gonna make it more likely they reach out to you. So whether you think it's obvious or not that you're looking for a new role, select that you are open to new opportunities. The next one, be descriptive of what roles you're looking for. When you do that, they're gonna give you the opportunity to write in there what you're looking for. And I know some people feel like, well, Ben, if I write something specific, I might not get messaged for other roles. And you know, I would counter that by saying, It's kind of a turnoff when someone doesn't say they're specifically interested in one thing. If you're interested in everything, we could assume that I don't know if they'll really be interested in my role. If you pick three or four types of roles you'd be interested in, you're gonna have a higher probability of someone reaching out to you because they see you're specifically interested in the role they're recruiting for. So be specific there. The next thing, join groups on LinkedIn. With a lot of people, like, you know, the HR group or open to networking, all those groups, you're probably thinking, Ben, why? Why would I do that if I am open to looking for a new role? How does that help me in my job search? And here's how. If you are in a group with someone, it doesn't cost anything to send them an in-mail. So as a recruiter, I actually am more likely to send out an in-mail to people who are in a group I'm in because it's free. So it's just removing a barrier. So I would definitely recommend if you're not in some groups, join some relevant groups. It could actually help your job search. All right, so the next thing, get your resume looking great. And I wanna make a point here. I don't have a service for resumes. I don't have a service for LinkedIn. It's just good advice. This is your product, you know, it is competitive out there. You wanna have a great looking LinkedIn and a great looking resume. It can only help you, so do that. Once you've done that, upload your resume, upload it to LinkedIn so people actually have a copy of your resume as well as your LinkedIn profile, but put it on CareerBuilder, put it on Monster, put it on Indeed. If you have a local job network, like the Milwaukee's local job network, throw it up there. Wherever you're at, make it as easy as possible for people to find you. You're gonna specifically look at roles and you're gonna apply to them, but you also want people coming to you. All right, so the next one. Customize your resume for the jobs you apply for. I know that sometimes looking for a new job can be like a full-time job in of itself. I totally get that. But when you see specific roles and you're reading through the job description, every single time, if you see, I've done that, they're looking for that, you need to put that into your resume. You know, I would go as far as in to copy some of that and then paste it into your resume and then modify it so it accurately reflects the things you have done. You know, you can go ahead and apply to 100 roles, but I think you'd actually be better served finding 10 roles you were well qualified for, customizing your resume for every single one, and then reaching out and applying with just like a great looking relevant resume. The next one, when you're applying on LinkedIn, it shows you who the job poster is. So if I post a job, you'll see, Ben White posted this job. You should reach out to me, send me a connection request, and in that spot where you can write nothing or you can customize a message, say, hey Ben, just applied to a role you posted. I feel like I'm a great fit. I'd love to connect with you. And then have them accept your, hopefully they accept your connection request, and then message them. And message them saying, don't just message them, hey, I applied. If you could take a look, that would be helpful. I want you to be specific. You know, talk about how you're a great fit, how you're interested in the role, and how you'd be open to answering any questions they might have. Make it easier for them. All right, so the next thing, network with specific headhunters in your niche. So if you reach out to me and you're looking for a specific role that I don't work in, say for example, healthcare, I am not the right person if you're a nurse. If you're a nurse, I know several people, but it's not me. I've never done any recruiting in there. What you want to do is network with headhunters who are obviously good at what they do. They're seasoned. You see, they have recommendations. They have over 500 connections. They've been with the same company for multiple years. People who are having success, what you want to do is connect with them and network with them. The reality is they have access to jobs that are not going to be posted online. At any given time, I might have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 roles that I have visibility to that aren't posted online. They're confidential. My client came to me and said, Ben, I need to find someone like this. The more headhunters that you are connected with who are in your industry, the greater access you will find yourself having to opportunities that might be a fit for you. So, a great place to do this is LinkedIn groups. If you're in construction, find a construction group, request entry to that, and then find the people who are construction recruiters and connect with them and introduce yourself and ask them what they might have that fits your background, and then explain what your background is. Again, make it easy for them, connect with them, and you're gonna increase the likelihood you're exposed to opportunities. All right, so the next one, reach out to past colleagues. This is a little bit of a weird one to some people because they're like, Ben, I don't wanna do that, it's awkward. But at the end of the day, I think it could be a huge help. One of the quickest, easiest ways to get a new job is be a referral. When a referral is in the applicant process, they are always viewed differently. So-and-so who has worked with our company and is doing a really good job recommended this person. What you have there is an inside track to the role. So I know it can be awkward when you're out of work to reach out and connect with other colleagues, former colleagues, but I would 100% do it. You miss 100% of the shots you don't take, and reaching out to them and saying, hey, just wanna let you know, I'm back on the market. I've really appreciated our time working together and I respect your opinion. And I just want you to know that if there's any opportunities you think I'd be qualified for, I'd love to hear about them. They might have one at their organization, or they might have a colleague who is looking for someone like this that they can share your background with. Again, it is something I would absolutely do. The next thing, so leverage LinkedIn to demonstrate your experience. I know a lot of people on LinkedIn talk about this, but when you post in your niche and you talk about your specific area, I think it's a good way to just kind of demonstrate your expertise. Post about your industry. You're going to get like-minded people commenting, engaging. Maybe some of those people are hiring. Maybe some of those people are recruiters and they're looking for people like you, and you make that connection. It's one of those things where it's just a high ROI, right? It takes very little in terms of energy and effort to just post out there about your industry, but it can position you as an expert or someone who's worth connecting with. I just think it's one of those things that you should definitely do. There's only so many jobs you can apply for. There's only so many times you can watch my videos and be ready to interview. But doing that could position you as an expert and could expose you to opportunities, so I'm 100% for it. Then the last one. In a normal year, I would tell you to attend virtual career fairs, or attend real career fairs, excuse me. In 2020 and early 2021, I would tell you to attend virtual career fairs and networking events. One of the most interesting things I think about 2020 and COVID-19 is that a ton of virtual webinars, networking events, career fairs have popped up more than ever before. And they are worth going to and attending. I've seen a ton of them in the last year that have come on, have been free, and you can attend as a candidate. I would 100% attend those. Even the webinars, if you go in there, you ask good questions, that could be a platform for you to start networking and engaging with people. So there you have it. Those are 11 tips. If you were in the job hunt, I know all of them probably weren't unique to you. Some of those you might be thinking, well, Ben, I'm already doing that. But I hope that some of the other ones were a benefit. And if you're already doing something, hopefully this reinforced that it's worth your effort. If you're seeing this on LinkedIn, please feel free to like and ask any questions or engage below. I always respond. If you're seeing this on YouTube, please like, please subscribe. If you have any questions, you can ask them there and I'll answer as well. And have a great day and good luck in your interviews.